In 1881, the Oto Missouri tribe was moved to what is now Red Rock, Oklahoma, making it their home and headquarters. 9 years later, the town of Red Rock was christened in northern Noble County, named after the close-by Red Rock Creek. In the late 1970s, Oklahoma Gas and Electric Company built a generating plant 6 miles east of town. With the extra property tax that the school district received, a new public school campus was established 1 mile east of Red Rock, and a new school building was completed in 1984. In 1989, the patrons of the Marlin School District decided to consolidate with Red Rock. As a result, the tax base grew much larger, enabling the community to develop one of the most modern schools in the state. It was then that the district's name was changed to Frontier. Frontier Schools offers a wide variety of activities for its students, including STEM clubs, vocal music, agricultural education, FFA, 4-H, athletics, art, Indian education, FCCLA, TSA, and academic team, to name a few. In April of 1991, a large F4 tornado touched down in our area that held the global record for highest recorded wind speed prior to the 1999 Bridge Creek Moore tornado. Because of our geographic location, storm and high wind speed events are much more common than in other districts throughout the state, yet we don't currently have a true FEMA-rated storm shelter. We currently use 3 different hardened rooms in our school that give students and faculty shelter, but none of these meet current FEMA guidelines or meet current code standards.
My name is Jarrah Kiespert, and I've been at Frontier for 6 years now. I am the pre-K through 6th principal. I have 2 children that go here. One is in 2nd grade and one in 4th. We came to Frontier in 2013, in July. On May 20th in 2013, we lost our home. I was teaching in Moore, and I taught there for about 10 years. And we were kind of looking for a change, but not that big of a change. So I left school early that day because we knew that there was impending weather. So I was able to go home and get my kids and take them across the street to a shelter. We didn't have one at my house. And we were able to sit there and ride out the storm, and when I came out, our house was gone. And as sad as I was so thankful that I had a neighbor who had left me a key, and I was able to protect my babies. Later that day, I found out that one of my co-teachers did not make it. And that was it was just so sad. And there were 7 children from a feeder school that they were 2 blocks away from the school that I taught at. And I just couldn't imagine. I still think about them a lot, what their parents went through. And luckily, I had applied to Frontier. They had a music position open. And so I had applied here, thinking I would be closer to my parents. I grew up in Perry, 15 minutes from here my whole life. Actually, I came and sang here a lot when I was a kid at different competitions, and reached out to Frontier. They gave me a job. They gave me a home. We lived here on campus for a year after the tornado to get back on our feet, and then we purchased a home, and now we're back up here living here on campus. We love it. I love this school. I love these kids. That experience is something that I never want another parent to have to go through. I don't want another coworker to ever have to go through that. I don't want to go to a funeral of a coworker.
Hi, I'm Bob Weckstein. I've been with Frontier Schools for 30 years in one capacity or another. I've been a coach, I've been a principal, and I've been your superintendent for the past 3 years. My wife has taught here for 25 years, both of my kids, Stacy and Reggie, have started here from preschool on and graduated. I've been a member of the community for 30 years. Prior to me becoming a superintendent after the Moore tornado, I became concerned about the safety of our students and staff here at Frontier. So once I became superintendent, I had Safe Schools 101. They're an organization that comes to schools and evaluates their existing tornado safe rooms, refuge areas, wherever you put our students in case of a tornado warning. I'll read the report. It says, during the school site and building assessment, the team discovered several areas of concern regarding sheltering of students, faculties, and guests during a potential high wind or tornado event. Their ultimate suggestion is that we build a safe room built to FEMA standards.
On February 12th, the district will be holding an election for a $1.2 million bond funding a new 500-person storm shelter building that will also serve as additional classroom space. The building will be easily accessible to the public. Located just east of the high school auditorium, the shelter will be located closest to our youngest students as well as give the best access to the outside community.
The tax impact will be minimal. If you pay $100 in taxes, they're estimating that your taxes will go up 32 cents a year. If you pay $1,000, they're estimating that your taxes will go up $3.20 a year. So we believe the trade-off is worth it to provide safety for our kids, your kids, and our staff. I'd like to encourage everyone to come out and vote February 12th. The polls are open 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Please come and vote.
The number one thing that we do here at school is provide safety for our children, all of our children. We talk about it in our administration meetings. We talk about it in our teacher meetings. That's our number one goal, is to provide safety for our kids. And so to have a room like this that we can go to and provide the community that reassurance that we're all going to be okay is priceless. It's priceless. On February 12th, I urge you to get out and vote and do what's right for our kids.